Hello and welcome to another video, and welcome aboard this train between London and Portsmouth. Now I'm actually heading today to the Isle of Wight, a very special part of England.
Today I was travelling on a hovercraft for the first time. The hovercraft is a British invention. In fact, the first passenger service ran from Rhyl in Wales to the Wirral. Due to their versatility, hovercraft have a myriad of uses, from sightseeing in the Arctic to military logistics craft. Some of us will also remember the heyday of the gigantic Saunders Row cross-channel passenger hovercraft that could even carry cars. But when these were scrapped 20 years ago, our Isle of Wight service became just about the world's only scheduled passenger hovercraft. A seasonal hovercraft exists crossing the border between Russia and China, and there are a few other occasional hovercraft services, but this really is, as far as I can tell, the only year-round passenger hovercraft in the world, and certainly the only one in Europe. So, how do you go about taking it? If, like me, you're arriving from London, you need to get off at Portsmouth and Southsea. The hovercraft leaves from a special landing stage in Southsea. It doesn't leave from the Portsmouth ferry port, so be sure not to stay on the train to Portsmouth Harbour. Make sure you take in the old booking hall here, which dates from the middle of the 19th century. Hover Travel, the operator of the hovercraft, runs a bus to connect with the hovercraft from places around Portsmouth. There's a modest fare, but remember you can get through rail tickets to the Isle of Wight that include the hovercraft and the bus trip.
Cheers, thank you.
You need to stop by the ticket office, either to buy a ticket or show your through train ticket to obtain a boarding card. There are no reservations on the ferry. It works just like a bus, and with it being the quickest way to cross the Solent, is quite popular. The service links two dedicated landing stages, one here in Southsea and the other in Ryde. Although our hovercraft crosses the Solent at one of its wider points, it's still only 7 kilometres and takes only 10 minutes to cross, less than half the time the fastest ferry takes. Hovercraft aren't ships or boats. Instead, they work by blowing air into a rugged inflatable cushion, meaning that they can travel over water with limited drag and friction, and also take on hard surfaces too. The hovercraft simply drives up onto the landing stage, and it's pretty cool to see if you've never witnessed it before. One of the fun things about the hovercraft is that it's so incredibly rare to travel on one, literally unique in Europe. Yet for most of these people, there's no sense of occasion. It's basically their bus to or from work. It's not romantic or epic, it's just very functional. But still, I was as excited to tick off my first hovercraft trip as I probably was to go on a bus for the first time as a toddler. After a short safety brief, we were off for our flight.
very loud and very bumpy.
Riding the hovercraft is an unusual experience. It's furiously loud and a very bumpy crossing, a bit like riding a motorbike over cobbles. And the craft is engulfed in its own spray for the whole crossing, meaning the video maybe wasn't as good as I'd imagined. Anyway, with reasonable fares and unbeatable journey times, why aren't there more passenger hovercraft around? Well, they're not cheap to run, are fairly noisy, which isn't friendly to the locals, and owing to their scarcity, a lack of spare parts mean that new seagoing ventures usually choose a conventional boat or ship. But hover travel is safe, these hovercraft are only a few years old, and the service provides a great alternative to the conventional ferries. There's no bridge, tunnel, or flights, so the vital link water transport plays to the Isle of Wight can't be understated. After 10 minutes, we approach Ryde Hoverport.
Thank you.
I know a lot of you will be wondering if I did the obvious thing when I was on the Isle of Wight. And yes, it was the real reason for my trip. The next video over this holiday period will be a fond farewell to the tiny tube trains on the Isle of Wight, which date from 1938.
So there you have it, that's Hover Travel, the world's only year-round commercial hovercraft service anywhere in the world, and it's right here in England. Really hope you've enjoyed this little bonus video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again in the next one. Thanks again for watching, and I hope you've had a safe and happy Christmas.